The Philippines seeks the release of Filipino seafarers held hostage by the Houthi group in the Red Sea. The palace said Friday some of the 17 Filipinos aboard the MV Galaxy Leader are showing symptoms of malaria. The honorary consul to Yemen is said to have asked the Sana'a government, which controls the Houthi, to release the crewmen on humanitarian grounds. Manila's Foreign Office says the Sana'a government has sent medical aid and doctors to the hostages. The Houthis seized a ship in November as a rebel group began attacks on vessels in the Red Sea and the Gulf of Aden. Brazil, Colombia, and Mexico call for an impartial verification of the results of Venezuela's presidential election amid questions over the legitimacy of President Nicolas Maduro's victory. Venezuela's Electoral Council proclaimed Maduro the winner with 51% of the vote. But the country's opposition says its tally of about 90% of the votes shows its candidate Edmundo Gonzalez received more than double the support of the incumbent. The opposition has released detailed tallies on a public website, but the government has so far not shared any information beyond a national total of votes for each candidate. The current presidents of Brazil, Colombia, and Mexico have traditionally been friendlier with Maduro and have adopted a more neutral stance on the election. Over in India, the death toll from the landslides in Kerala nears 200. The latest count, 189. But that number is expected to rise as search efforts continue for the hundreds more who remain missing. The disaster was the worst in Kerala since deadly floods in 2018. Experts said the area had received heavy rain in the last 2 weeks that softened the soil before extremely heavy rainfall on Monday triggered the landslides. The Philippine Justice Secretary eyeing a class suit over the oil spill in Bataan, which has triggered a fishing ban on affected areas. Secretary Jesus Crispin Rimulya met with the Oil Spill Interagency Committee at the Justice Department Friday, attended by Cavite Governor John Vic Rimulya, the Coast Guard Commandant, and several other government officials. Eight towns earlier declared a state of calamity after oil from the sunken MTKR Terra Nova reached Cavite's coastline. The tanker sank in bad weather last July 25. It was carrying around 1.4 million liters of industrial fuel oil. Rimulya's basis for a possible class suit involves the oil spill's adverse effect on fisherfolk.
We're not talking about an accident here. We're talking about a crime. A crime was committed against our people and our environment. We're looking into the angle of a class suit already. Filed by the fishermen against the owners and others, no, who may be responsible for this.
Fishermen and fish vendors in Cavite still reeling from the effects of the Bataan oil spill as the provincial government distributes aid to affected fisher folk in Noveleta. Izzy Lee joins us on the line for details. Izzy?
Denise, some fish vendors have temporarily closed their market stall in Noveleta, Cavite, due to the significant decrease in customers after news of an oil spill in Cavite spread. Other fish vendors are also struggling selling their fish at a loss. They are sourcing from fish ponds to ensure the fish is safe to eat, but still no one is buying. Meanwhile, boats in Long Beach, Noveleta remain docked as fishermen are unable to go out of the sea. On Wednesday, Cavite Governor John Vic Rimulya declared a state of calamity for the coastal municipalities due to the impact of oil spill. The provincial government of Cavite also clarified that there is no fishing ban in the province and only a no-cats and no-sell zone for all shellfish is being enforced in coastal towns. According to the Department of Agriculture, Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources, or DABFAR, bulletin released on August 1, they are monitoring fishing areas in Region 3, Calabarzon, and NCR that might be affected. Fish samples are being taken from these areas to check for oil and harmful substances to ensure seafood is safe to eat. The DABFAR advises that fish from areas with visible oil slick should not be eaten to avoid incidents of food poisoning. They continue to inspect markets to ensure the seafood sold is safe and good quality. Denise?
Izzy Lee with that report. Thanks, Izzy.